Hello, I'm Jan Pinkava, the writer and director of Geri's Game. I'm going to tell you a little bit about it as it runs. Geri's Game was really started as the first short film at Pixar after John Lasseter's five short films. And we wanted to do two things, make a great short film and also do some research and development in human characters. It turns out that it's very difficult to do human characters in our medium, in computer animation. And we needed to solve a couple of technical things to be able to have human characters in all our stories at Pixar. Here's Geri the old man unloading his chess pieces on a beautiful autumn day. And he keeps them in a box of cigars which say, Pixar Shorts, Point Richmond, handmade. And even the torn little label on the side of the cigar box is actually got the old Pixar logo on it. The old man in the story is actually inspired by my grandfather, who lived to a ripe old age and throughout his life played chess. And the story is a story about one character and trying to write a story that has just one character in it and some conflict. Turned out that we needed a weird situation like this where the old man is actually pretending to be two people. This is my favorite shot in the film, where we really get the sense of Geri as an old man moving from one chair to the other. And then, bam, he's this younger, sprightlier other self at the other side of the board. There were actually 19 animators who worked on Geri's Game, and that for me was quite a challenge as a director to try and keep all the performances consistent enough so that we feel that we have just one guy or two guys in the story. I think everyone did a great job on that. The music, Gus Vizer and his orchestra, Flambe Montalbanais, is one of my favorite pieces of French musette music, and I think really is half the story, sets the scene beautifully. Ha! You can really hear the excellent sound work by Tom Myers at Skywalker Sound. There's one shot that we see right there where we actually see both Geri's in frame at the same time, which is kind of an in-joke, because of course really there's just one man there. Also, the lighting actually changes throughout the film so that it's like Geri was playing this game against himself throughout the whole day, and the sun has tracked across the sky. It took about 1.5 years to make this short film from the very beginning, half that time spent on actually storyboarding it and getting the story right and working very hard to make it play in the form of story reels, just still pictures, before we actually started production. When we first got to this point in the story, I was kind of wondering maybe if that wasn't a little bit too harsh for Geri to kind of die. And often audiences breathe a sigh of relief when they see him coming up again. When Geri turns the chessboard around here, he knocks the box of chess pieces onto the floor. And you'll notice that when we pull out at the end of the film, that box of chess pieces isn't there. And a lot of people have asked me where they went. And the answer is, we just forgot to put them in there. We actually sent a tape of this to the American Chess Federation, who'd heard that we'd made a film about chess. And we never got a reply as to what they really thought of the game. I suspect that they didn't think it was particularly good as a chess game. But of course, that's not the point of the story. Michael Cass, who wrote the software for the cloth dynamics, which is the computer calculating how all that cloth should move, his reward was that nobody notices his work and thinks there's just cloth on the screen. This is exactly how I want to be when I'm Geri's age.